The United States faces today a crisis, a potential catastrophe that will affect not only its national security, but I believe its society, its way of life, if corrective action is not taken promptly.
Let me be honest. The vision is realistic that in 20 years, this whole world could collapse. Because if things look bad in the Middle East now, look at what's going to happen when oil dependency and prices become 10 times the problem they are today. There is hope, if we work at top speed, that we can get the new cars on the road in 5 years so that we have 10 years to turn over the auto fleet so we just barely avoid catastrophe. If we don't change, our future is really at risk. We are in a scary situation. And everybody, whether you work for an oil company or anybody else, your future is in trouble. And the best we can do is to work as hard and as fast as we can to make this transition before it's too late.
If we lose just 2 million barrels a day, or 10%, the government can't even chart the impact on our society. It will become neighbor against neighbor, Mad Max, citizen against citizen, massive food shortages, unemployment, complete economic collapse. And the problem is, there is no plan in the United States to deal with this emergency. This is not energy independence. This is energy crisis. And no one is even discussing it. Not the Democrats, not the Republicans, not the White House, not the governors.
The objective is to turn oil into salt. Salt was once a strategic commodity. The stature of countries on the world stage was determined by their access to salt. Wars were fought over salt because salt was the only means to preserve food, to preserve meat. With the advent of canning and electricity and refrigeration, salt lost its strategic value. Now you had other options. We can and must do the same thing to oil. Technology can strip oil of its strategic status and turn it into just another commodity. We're always going to use oil, we're always going to need oil, but it should be just another commodity traded on the market, not one that determines world affairs.
What is the problem with our energy system in the world today? The fact is that 96% of our transportation energy, that's all the cars, trucks, ships, planes, railways, are all dominated by petroleum. When you buy a car today, the car can run on nothing but petroleum. So we have a monopoly of petroleum in the transportation sector. That is a sector that moves people and goods around the world. Without transportation, there is no world economy.
We also have malignant and malevolent problems with transportation, which is 97% dominated by oil. Hurricane Katrina nearly took out the major pipeline that runs up the east coast of the United States, and we could have had a very serious emergency here for a long time if we hadn't been as lucky as we were. But oil's big vulnerability is to malevolent interference, and that can occur in a whole host of ways because of its location. Heavily in the Middle East and in dictatorships and autocratic kingdoms. 8 of the 9 leading exporters of oil in the world are dictatorships and autocratic kingdoms, and that creates a very serious problem.
We are addicted to foreign oil. We are sending over $500 billion a year to countries which really don't like us and share our interests and values. And today we have Iran building nuclear weapons. We have Saudi Arabia, which is funding radical Islam around the world. And this is a significant concern for our national security, our economic security, our well-being, and the values and interests that we hold dear.
I'm concerned about an attack on a Saudi terminal. First, because Al-Qaeda has stated publicly that they understand what a devastating effect that would have by removing a significant amount of oil from the global economy. 4 to 6 million barrels per day, which is what is processed at Ras Tanura or Abqaiq, literally could run the price of oil to more than $200 a barrel. A quadrupling of the price of gasoline would mean that our transportation system first would be paralyzed, and then the entire global economy would grind to a halt.
The oil market is controlled by a cartel. The OPEC cartel, we have 13 governments that control 78% of the world's oil. So on the one hand, we have a cartel. On the other hand, we have a monopoly. And this combination is extremely toxic and very dangerous to the future of our civilization.
Lawrence Wright in The Looming Tower, which I think is the best book on 9/11, says that with a little over 1% of the world's Muslims, the Saudis control about 90% of the world's Islamic institutions. That means those institutions teach the beliefs of Wahhabi Islam, hatred, really virtually genocidal hatred, for Shiite Muslims, Jews, homosexuals, and apostates, and massive repression of everybody else, including especially women. Those views are essentially the same substantive views as those of Al-Qaeda. Al-Qaeda and the Wahhabis really just disagree about who should be in charge, not about substantive underlying views.
One thing is certain. We don't know when. We don't know exactly how. But at some point in the not too distant future, something is going to be done to interrupt the flow of oil to this country.
People wonder, if the American public is lethargic and they're not acting, why doesn't the Congress recognize that there's a problem? Why don't they do something? Well, the Congress hasn't acted for the same reason that the American people really haven't acted, and that's, again, been cheap gas prices at the pump.
The one piece of really good news is that we have an alternative to perpetuating our present vulnerable state vis-a-vis oil. We have the opportunity to start requiring the cars sold in America, the new cars sold in America, to be equipped with something called flexible fuel vehicle technology.